Pinch points focus on particular chunks of knowledge and understanding. We've created a diagnostic question which helps to understand why students have got a particular concept wrong, and then the following interventions help students address those misconceptions and improve. What makes pinch points different to other similar intervention activities is that we are looking at the types of mistakes students make, and we've got interventions that challenge those specific issues. Pinch points came about when I came up with an idea after reading a book by Professor Keith Tabor, who's a science education researcher. He identified these four different types of mistakes that children make when doing science. So the first idea is that they make a mistake because they've just got missing knowledge. The second type of mistake is because they haven't got a connection, a particular connection, there's a missing connection. The next one is about a misunderstanding, they've misunderstood something. And the final one is about a misconception, something deeply held in them that they find it difficult to understand the new science concept. We developed the pinch points over 2 years. I came with an original idea of taking each of the difficult concepts in the science curriculum and developing a pinch point activity with the four different mistake outcomes. This proved to be quite overwhelming. There's an awful lot of concepts in science, so we brought them right down to some key ones that all children find particularly difficult. We took these ideas to conferences where there were science teachers, for example the Association for Science Education annual conference, and teachers fed back to us what they thought of them, how they felt that they could be developed, and we went away and we developed a series of activities. Following that, we brought our activities to teachers at a similar conference, and they were able to feedback how they felt they could use these activities in the classroom, and we started to think about how we could develop them so that teachers could use them in the most effective way for themselves.